Almighty to have the privilege of being able to come to you one more time. We bless and praise the name of our God, for he is worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun until the going down of the same. He's worthy. We thank God for the privilege of being able to come to you all where you are and to let you know that there is no secret what God can do. He bless your neighbor. He bless you too. If you keep your hands in God's hands, things don't always work the way you want to, but things always work the way God intend for them to work. And we are aware that all things work together for good for those who love the Lord, for those who are called according to his purposes. Let us bow our heads in a word of prayer. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, thou who does all things well, we come to you now. Heads bowed, the locks of our shoulders, but our hearts are lifted to the God of our salvation. 10,000 tones would not be sufficient enough to give you the praise, to give you the glory, to give you the adoration for the things that you have done. But now in this manner, we know how. We want to say thank you. Thank you, my Father, for keeping us from infancy until the present moment. Truly, we can say that the Lord is blessing us right now. Now, Master, all of us have been made with purpose and with reason. If for no other reason, to let someone else know that you're alive and that you're real and that you've come into this world that they too might have life and have it more abundantly. So use us to your glory. Allow us to impart to others the things that you would have us to know, the things that you would have us to do. Always make us mindful of the fact that without you we are nothing, but with you all things are possible. We pray a special blessing upon the church family for 153 years you have brought us. Dangers seen and unseen, made a way out of no way. Thank you, my Master. Keep us ever under the shadow of your mighty wings. Always have us to be witnesses of what you can do, for we realize that without you we can do nothing, but with you all things are possible. Now, my Master, open our hearts that we may hear what your Spirit is saying to the church. In the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. In the fourth chapter of the book of Luke. Fourth chapter of the book of Luke. I'd like to begin my reading at verse 1. And I'd like to read a little bit of Luke for your consideration. I'd like to read about 21 verses. And Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterwards hungered, and the devil said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. Jesus answered him, saying, It is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. And the devil, taking him up into a high mountain, showed unto him all the kingdoms of the world in the moment of time. And the devil said unto him, All this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that is delivered unto me, and to whomever I will give it. If thou therefore wilt worship me, all shall be thine. Jesus answered and said unto him, Get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. And he brought him to Jerusalem and said, Set him on a pinnacle of the temple and said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down from hence. For it is written, He shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. And Jesus answered and said unto him, It is said, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And when the devil had ended all the temptation, he departed from him for a season. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. And there went out a fame of him through all the region round about. And he taught in their synagogues, being glorified of all. And he came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he had anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And he closed the book, and he gave it again to the minister and sat down, and the eyes of all them that were in the synagogue were fastened on him. Jesus appeared to mankind in a multiplicity of different ways. But he comes to let man know that there is a way that is mighty sweet. Man, by his instinct, lives the way he feels he ought to live. But the truth of the matter is that God gives man the opportunity to live his life not for himself, but to live his life to advance the kingdom cause of Christ in the manner in which he lives. Jesus had to set this example. He could tell man that that's the way man ought to live, but the best way to teach anyone to follow the example that is set before them is not to talk the talk, but to walk the walk. Jesus appeared full of the Holy Ghost, returning to the Jordan. And the Bible says he was led of the Spirit into the wilderness. He followed the Spirit. The first thing that I would have
all of us to know is that we need to learn to trust the Spirit of Almighty God. We trust everything else, every inclination, every hunch, every desire of someone else's heart, but we need to learn to trust what God sets before us. If God sets something before you, there's something in it for you. There's something in it that you must do. But don't you ever feel that you have accomplished all that God wants you to accomplish until you hear from Jesus, "Well done, good and faithful servant." You know, the truth of the matter is, all of us have come this far by faith. Sometimes up, sometimes down. But the best one of us looks back over our life and realizes that there's some things that I should not have done. And you take that to Jesus in prayer. You see, when you try to carry the stuff that ends up carrying you, then it drives you to a place that only God can make a difference in your life. Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being hungry for 40 days. And there he was tempted of the devil. That's one thing that Satan always does. Satan finds a way of interfering with whatever you're doing that God wants you to do. Satan always finds a way of trying to get you to take your attention off of what God would have you to do in order for you to listen to what he has to say. Oftentimes you hear people say, "Get thee behind me, Satan." But the truth of the matter is that if you listen to Satan, then he'll drive you to where he wants you to be. He comes to Jesus. Satan, 40 days after not eating, 40 days after not having digested any food in his system, his body was weak. His mind was strong. See, the difference between you and Jesus is that you cannot take 40 days without food. But Jesus, 40 days. And he had a mind stayed on the things that his father sent him to do. Satan raised the question after 40 days. He realized that he's hungry. It wasn't hard to figure that out because he was very God of very God. He was also very man. He was hungry 40 days without food. So Satan used that opportunity to tempt Jesus. That's what Satan does. Satan finds the weakest point in a human's existence, and there is where he will place the greatest amount of pressure for temptation. I don't care what it is. It can be your health. It can be your wealth. It can be your children, but whatever it is that Satan needs to use to tempt you is the thing that Satan will push your buttons on. Satan comes to Jesus in that fourth chapter, and he says to Jesus, "If thou be the Son of God." Now, the first mistake that Satan made was Satan doubted the authenticity of who God is. That's always the way Satan operates. Satan has you to doubt the one who has sent you. Remember when Satan appeared to Adam in the garden, Satan said that God didn't surely say that you would die. Satan always attacks the one in which you have a core belief. Satan comes to Jesus himself and he says to Jesus, "If." What do you mean, if? Jesus knows who he is. And the way that you can resist the power of Satan to become something that you are not designed to be is to never lose track with who you are. I know that we have all types of people that we are impressed with. But you have to realize this. If God made them into who they are, then God is able to make you into who He wants you to be. Simple prayer. Create in me a clean heart. Renew a right spirit in me. Satan comes to Jesus at a moment of weakness, at a moment of vulnerability, at a moment where you and I would be vulnerable to any suggestion to satisfy our bodies. And He says to Jesus, if thou be the Son of God, command these stones to be turned to bread. Jesus was hungry. All He had to do was speak a word. And stone would have been turned to bread. But listen to what Jesus says. Jesus says to Satan, it is written. It is written. You have the weapon. We go to many people for many things. We ask people all types of questions. We ask people what we think they should know because some of them have been around longer. Before you ask anybody anything, you take it to God in prayer. Jesus said, it is written. You see, you have the Word of God. And if you would apply yourself to the Word of God, God will direct your path. Jesus said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. See, Jesus wanted us to recognize, not him. He recognized. He knew. He simply wanted to state to Satan, for your sake and for my sake, that we don't live for bread. But as long as we live, God will supply our needs according to His riches. You see, so many of us are driven by our needs, what we want. And the truth of the matter is, the more we get, the more we want. And whatever we get, it comes through the hands of God. Jesus says to Satan, man does not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeded out the mouth of God. In other words, when you're hungry, God makes a way for you. When you can't see your way, God makes a way for you. When you don't know where to go, God shall supply your need. And the devil, he doesn't give up. That's one thing about Satan that I've noticed. He'll go for a season. But he always tempts us. He always tricks us. He always traps us. The devil takes him up to a high mountain. Shows him a kingdom, a world, and in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, all this power will I give thee, and the glory of them, for that is delivered unto me, and to whomever I will give it. Therefore will worship me, and it shall be thine. Here's the thing that Jesus knew. The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. the cattle on a thousand hill belong to him. If God makes you steward of them, then you handle them according to the will of God. Because if God be for you, who's the whole world that's against you? Jesus tells Satan, he lets him know that everything belongs to God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, get thee behind me, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. You see, it's difficult for you and I to decide whom we're going to serve. We serve ourselves. We serve others. We seek to gratify everyone other than the one we ought to serve. He sings a song, all to Jesus I surrender, all to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily. Live, I surrender all to Jesus I surrender. I surrender. Make up in your mind who you going to serve, because the day is coming when you either bow before his presence or either you'll be forced to your face. But you will give an account unto God for the deeds that have been done in your body. And on that day, my hopes, my prayers are that you be able to say, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shall thou serve. And when he had brought him to Jerusalem, set him on a pinnacle in the temple, and said unto him, if thou be the Son of God. This question he keeps raising, if thou be the question that questions the identity of Jesus. Jesus knew who he was. And I think that we get tempted and torn all out of whack because we forget who we are. We are children of the King. Well, I know you have a mother and you have a father. I have a mother, I have a father too. But more than anything, I'm a child of the King. I don't make my decision based on what my mother, my father did. I make my decision based on what God has done for me. God has brought me from a mighty long way. And whenever someone has brought you from such a long way, then you need to take your burdens to the Lord and leave them there. And he brought him to Jerusalem, set him on the pinnacle of the temple, and said unto him, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down from thence. For it is written, he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest that any time thou dashest thy foot against the stone. Jesus said, it is said, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And when the devil had ended all the temptation, he departed from him for a season. One thing about Satan that I must conclude this message with, he will never quit. He will use whatever he can use to turn your soul away from God. What you must do, all to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily. Live. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender. I surrender all. And when the going gets rough and you can't see your way, just ask the Savior to help you. Comfort, strengthen, and keep you. He is willing to aid you. He will carry you through. May God bless you. May God keep you. Ever is my prayer.